This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This video is an introduction to simple interest, what it is, and the simple interest formula. So on this video, we work through three problems computing simple interest using the formula I equals PRT. This is an introduction to simple interest. Here's an example. How much interest would you earn after 1 year if you put $2,000 in a bank that pays a 10% simple interest rate? So what this means is you're putting $2,000 in the bank at the end of the year, 10% of that much money is what you earn in interest. So I imagine many of you could do this without knowing any kind of formula. You would earn 10% of $2,000. All right, so you would earn 10% of $2,000. Now, you could use a calculator to figure that out. I just think of this as a fraction. 10% is 1/10 of $2,000. And then you can cancel out. 10 goes into that number. It's going to be $200. So this is how much you earn in interest by putting $2,000 in the bank as opposed to under your mattress. So you now have how much in the account? Oops, not mommy, money. How much money is now in the account? So what would that be? Well, you had $2,000, you earned $200, so you have $2,000 plus $200. So you now have that much money in the account. Now, I wish banks paid that interest rate. It's pretty low as I do this writing, but if they did give you a 10% interest rate, that's what it would be. Now, another problem might be you lent $2,000 to a friend, and maybe you only charge them 4% interest, etc. It would be done the same way. This is how much you earn at the end of a year. The reason it's called simple interest is the interest isn't computed except once a year, basically. So if you only put the money in for half a year, you would get half as much interest. You would earn $100, etc. If you put it in for 5 years, you would earn five times as much interest, which would be $1,000. Okay? So what we're going to go on to now is an actual formula. It's called the simple interest formula. So the simple interest formula is I equals PRT. Now this means P times R times T. And so these are variables. And this is what each one stands for. I stands for interest. It's the amount of interest or the money you're going to earn. Okay. Principal. That's referring to the amount of money you borrowed, lended, or deposited in a bank, for instance. R is the annual percentage rate. It's usually called a rate. When you go to the bank, you say, what are the rates? So instead of writing P for percent, we use R for rate, but it really is usually given in percent form. And T is the time in years. What this allows us to do is to figure out how much interest you earn for, you know, not only just at the end of a year, etc. By the way, there are other formulas for interest called compound interest, and this would be, for instance, if every month or every day they figured out how much you owed, let's say if you borrowed money, how much you owed right then and there, they add that and then take the they keep on compounding the interest, so you end up paying a lot more at the end of the year. Or if you're lending money, you end up earning more at the end of the year. And I might get to an example of that a little bit later. All right, so for now, we've got the simple interest formula. So let's see how we would do this problem using this particular formula. So this was our problem. And this one was easy to figure out without a formula, but we could state what goes here for our variables. So Says, how much would you earn after 1 year if you put $2,000 in a bank that pays 10% simple interest? And usually it'll just say that pays at a rate of 10%. So I don't know the interest. That's what I'm looking for. So I don't have that. How much am I putting in the bank? That's this $2,000. And let's just leave off the dollars for now. Later we will make sure that we, oops, I meant to put that in the principal. It's the principal. 10%. Okay, when you see the percent, that's the interest rate. And we want to write that as either a fraction or a decimal. I'm going to go ahead and write it as a decimal. Usually it's written as a decimal, but you could write it as a fraction as well. And what's the time? 1 year. So that's one. So if we use our formula, we would say the interest, which is what we're looking for, is 2,000 times 0.1 times 1. And if you were using a calculator, this would be easy to do. But if you weren't doing a calculator, I hope you see that it's also going to be easy to do. You're going to get that to be 200, because when you multiply by 0.1, it just moves the decimal one in to the left. If you written 1/10, also, it'll just cancel one of those zeros. So the interest earned here is $200, which we already figured out, and so that's our answer. So that was an fairly easy problem. All right, so why don't you try this problem? John invests $6,000 in an account that earns 7% per year. How much interest does he earn after 2 years? Now notice I'm not saying that this is simple interest. We're going to assume that unless it says otherwise. Okay, so we know the formula is interest equals principal times rate times time, and we're looking for the interest. So what's our principal? That's how much money he puts in the bank, 6,000. What's the rate? Well, we've got 7%. You can either write that, you could just write 7% here, but when we plug it in the formula, we want to write it as either 0.07 or 7 hundredths. That's up to you. Depending on if you're doing it by hand or with a calculator, and whether you like to work with fractions or decimals. So that's up to you. And what's the time? How many years is this? We have 2 years. So if we want to know the interest, the principal is 6,000. And what's the rate? I'm going to use 7 hundredths because I see that's going to cancel very nicely. So I'm going to multiply it by 7 hundredths. And then what's the time times 2? Let's see if anything cancels. 100 goes into that 6,000, canceling out two of those zeros. So what do I have left here? I've got 60 times 7 times 2. All right, so the easy way to do that is do 6 times 7, which is 42, times another 2, which is 84. But it was really 60, so you get to add that 0 at the end. So at the end of 2 years, the interest is 840, and remember, it's asking how much interest he earns. So our final answer really should be in a sentence, or at least with a dollar bill. So he earns $840 in interest after 2 years. Now, the question may have been different. It may have said, how much money is in the bank after 2 years? So how would we do that problem? What if the question had been, how much money is in the account after 2 years? So the idea is that they put the interest in the account, and he originally had $6,000, and now he has 840 more dollars because of the interest. So we would take and add those together, the 6,000 plus 840, right? So our answer is going to be $6,840 is now how much money he has in the account. All right, here's our next problem. How much interest would you pay your friend after 6 months if she lent you $500 at a rate of 8%? We're assuming that means 8% simple interest. Also, what is the money owed to the friend if you pay off the loan at 6 months? So we need to figure out the interest you owe at 6 months. So let's figure out our principal, our rate, and our time. So how much money is she lending? $500. And what's the rate? The rate is 8%. So we could write that as 0.08 or 0.08. And what's the time? There's the tricky part. The time is always in years. So if we've got 6 months, you have to think, well, how many months are in a year? 6 out of 12, right? It's only 6 of the 12 months. So the time is only half a year. So our interest will be the 500 times, I'm going to write that as 800s, but you can, of course, do this with calculators if you're allowed. And the time is one half. So we're doing principal times rate times time. And let's see, the hundredths cancels with this. Now, in real life, usually you can't do it without a calculator, but I'm giving you easy enough numbers here. Let's see, anything else cancel? The 2 goes into that 8, right? So that'll be 4. So it looks like my total interest is $20, 5 times 4. So the first question is you're going to pay $20 in interest, right? The second question, what's the money owed to the friend if you pay off the loan at 6 months? Well, you certainly have to pay back the $500 plus the interest. So the payback is going to be $500 to pay off the loan. All right, so we'll do a lot more problems on subsequent videos. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.